Hey everyone, Amelia Roberts here, and in this video, I am going to show you a few different little tips and tricks in Power BI that will make the biggest difference. Now, I'm gonna start off in the Power Query Editor, show you a few things there. We're gonna move into the Power BI Desktop, and then of course, into the service. I wanna just show you a couple of things that I have learned throughout my Power BI journey that have really made a big impact on my report building process. Let's head on over to my laptop and check it out. All right, so here we are in the Power Query Editor, and I am just going to show you a couple of different things within here. So the first two little tips are over here in our applied steps, actually. There are a few things you can do here to just add very small touches to help in the organization and understanding of the steps that you did. One of those is being you can right click on any step and you can go down to properties. Once you open this up, you can add a description here that will explain what change you made and why you did that. So promoted headers is not the best choice here, but if I wanted to put this something on like change type, I can go to my properties and I can say like changed to text to get rid of or to bring back leading zeros, for instance. So you can add something like a little note, and then this little information thing will come up. If you scroll over it, it will tell you kind of a little bit more about why you did that step along the way. This is really great if you have multiple people with hands on a report or on a data set on a semantic model, because sometimes things can get handed off to somebody else and they can question, why did they do that? Well, now you can kind of put it in there so they don't have to ask you about it. Another thing you can do over here in your applied steps, and I won't be able to show you because it's not happening on any of these, but if I right click, I have the ability right here where it says view native query. I can check for query folding. Now, query folding in Power BI is like giving instructions to the database to do heavy lifting for us. So instead of pulling all the data into Power BI and then transforming it, query folding kind of sends the transformation steps back to the database. So this way the database processes the data and sends only the results back to Power BI, and this makes data processing faster and more efficient. Kind of think of it, this is how I always think of it, I love a good metaphor. Think of it like ordering a custom-made pizza. Instead of getting all the ingredients at the store and having to make it yourself, you just tell the pizzeria exactly what you want and they deliver the finished pizza to you. So this can be used for tasks like filtering rows, grouping data, joining tables, and it can be managed by the database, which results in faster processing. This is how you can see if a step is being done, if query folding is happening. So if this is not grayed out, that means query folding is happening and you can click on that and check it out. One more thing I want to point out here in the Power Query Editor before we move back into the desktop is we all know that the Power Query Editor will only give us our top 1,000 rows. Now that can be a little difficult for filtering. We go into something, I have my customer key here. If I drop this down, it says my limit of 1,000 values is reached. That can be kind of frustrating at times, I can imagine, but there are definitely ways around this. I can go to this numbers filter here, and I can just choose whichever one I want. I do not want to insert a step. I didn't realize I was highlighted on something else there, but I can go to my number filters, go to equals. And when this comes up, I have the option of having this like basic where I can filter out things that are specific. So equal to, between, does not equal, greater than equal to, and I can select a value here. Now you do kind of need to know your data set, but you have some options here, and then you also have this advanced option as well. So there are more ways to filter the data in each column other than just clicking on those check marks. So definitely something to look into if you are coming across that little boundary and you're unsure what to do. You do have some other options Here, I'm going to hit cancel because I actually don't want to filter this. You also, just so you know, on the bottom, everything is typically profiled based on the top 1,000 rows. You can have column profiling based on your entire data set. If you want to see information about column profiling, that is in your view, and you can hit column profile and it will give you information based on that. You can change it instead of the 1,000. You can have it based on the whole data set for that information. Now, let's go back into our desktop here. I am just going to hit close and apply and go back into my report here. Now, this is just a report I have made for an example from a class I taught, but it has a lot of great data in here, and there are some really cool things that I want to show you. So something small that can really make a big difference on a visual, I'm gonna go ahead and make this visual here a little bit bigger for us. But one thing that a lot of people ask about is, can I add just like the specific numbers on each of these bars so it's more accessible and readable? Of course you can. Those are called data labels. So we can go to our format, our visual button, as long as our visual is selected. When you choose here, you can go down to this area right here called data labels and turn that on. This will add data labels to your visual, and there are so many customizations in here that you can change as well. So definitely something to look into. You can change the position, you can change the value, you can change the text of it. You can also what kind of units you want to display, decimal places, all of that really great stuff that kind of just elevates that visual to a more readable and accessible visual for a wider audience. And it really hits that 5-second rule where I can look at something and get a lot more information. So another thing that I can do is I can do custom formatting in my model view here on the Power BI desktop. So all I have to do is go over to my model view on my left-hand side. And how you can access this is all you have to do is select a column. So I'm just gonna choose sales territory country, something random here, just to give you an idea of where this is. Once I select that in my properties pane here, it's gonna give me a lot of information about my column. But down here, it is going to have formatting, and I have a data type here, and then I also have this format down here. If I select this, I have this custom option here, and I guess this wasn't the best choice to do. Let me see if it'll give me another one. Oh, here we go. I have this custom option here. If I select this, then I can customize the format in which I have this. So there's this learn more option here. If you want to get more information about custom formatting for a column, then I would definitely look here. But this is like a little known thing that not many people are aware exists. And of course, Power BI and Microsoft have offered an ability to get more information on it right here in Power BI, which is so nice to have. The last thing I want to show you here in the desktop is how to create a table to house your measures. So one thing I personally cannot stand is when my measures are just all over the place over here in my data pane. So I really like to keep them all in one place. And the way I personally do that is I create something like this called a measure table. Now, it is not a table. It will show up in your data model, but it is not something that you need to necessarily connect or make relationships with. It is just a place to house your measures for organizational purposes. How I do this is I go up to enter data at the top. I select enter data, and this blank table with a blank column is going to come up. I am going to name this table something about measures. I typically also always put an asterisk before it so that it goes to the top of my data pane, because remember, it is in alphabetical order. I cannot change that order. It is what it is. So I cheat it by doing an asterisk, and then I call it something like measures, measure table. I've already named one measures, so I can't do that again, but I'm going to go ahead and call it tester for now. And then I'm going to hit load. Once I do that, it is going to appear over in my data pane. We can see it right here, and it has a blank column here. Now, how do I get my measures there? You're probably wondering. So if I select one of my measure tools is going to come up at the top. I can go over to my home table area, drop this down, because measures can be housed in any table. So I can choose whatever table I want them to be housed in. A lot of people choose to keep all theirs in their fact table, but I can move it to whatever table I choose. So now you can see that measure has moved to the tester table. I also have this blank column right here. Once I've added a measure to it, I can go ahead and delete that column from my data model. And now this is my little measure table where it's going to house all my measures. As I make measures, I just tend to go up and hit that home table and fix it while I'm in there. So let's move on from here to the Power BI service for some more information here. This is once again, just another random report I've made. I am a huge Ohio State fan, go Buckeyes. Here I'm gonna give you just a couple of little tips that I really like to know about and I like to share with other people. The first is alerts. I love setting alerts. I think this is a great feature, especially for something like a card or a gauge. I really love them on a gauge visual because of that target goal that you have on a gauge. I don't have a gauge here to show you, but I do have a card in it that I can use. But what this is I can set an alert when this visual, when this metric hits something specific. So you can go here, you can choose the measure, which this is count of bank name, which is a horrible name for a measure, but it is what it is. And then I can choose changes, comes greater than, changes from, less than, whatever it may be. I like changes because typically that means it's going up or down in some way. I also like when it becomes greater than, and then you can choose a threshold pretty much that you want your metric to hit. This is great for the gauge. You put your goal in there and then you are going to get an email or a Teams message, depending on whichever one you choose, when you meet that value, when whatever you choose happens. So I love that for the gauge because it's usually something like your profit is on the gauge and you want to know when you hit your goal profit for the year. So it's a great way to get that nice and exciting. You get that email that says you've met your goal. I think it's really fun and just really different. So that is setting an alert once again up here at the top next to your edit button. One last thing I am going to show you in here that I really like is under these ellipses here, these more options. I love this see related content. Why do I like this? Because it tells me what my report is attached to, where it comes from, and it also tells me this great piece of information right here, last refreshed. I can also refresh my data here if I want to. I can schedule my refreshes here. I can also create a report from the semantic model here. There is a lot of great stuff going on and it's just right there on the page. I don't have to go all into my workspaces, into all these crazy places. I can just grab it right here, check it out, apply a refresh, schedule a refresh if I want to. It's nice and simple and easy to get to without jumping all over the place. I hope that this little tidbit of information in Power BI, the desktop Power Query Editor in the Power BI service, just these small tweaks can make big impacts on what you are doing with your data. I hope it was helpful and beneficial, and I will see you in the next video.